and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, then welcome. My name is Alejandra and I usually post videos about pregnancy since I am currently pregnant. I'm 30 weeks pregnant now with the baby girl. If you haven't seen any of my previous videos, definitely go ahead and watch them. They have very helpful information. And if you are a previous subscriber, then welcome back. Now, don't forget to like and subscribe if you are new here. Now, today's video, as you guys read on the title, is going to be about Bicornuate uterus update. I know a lot of you guys have found me through Instagram, through my Bicornuate uterus post, or even on here on Instagram and have shared your stories with me in regards to also bringing awareness to pregnancy loss. Now, if you guys do know, I have a Bicornuate uterus now. For Bicornuate uterus, as I explained in a previous video, a C-section is more common. Now, I just wanted to give you guys a little update as far as how pregnancy has been with a Bicornuate uterus. I've never been pregnant before, so I don't know what like a regular pregnancy would feel like without a Bicornuate uterus, or in general, since, you know, this is my first baby. But from my experience, what I can share with you guys is definitely ask your doctor what side your baby implants, so you can know, like, well, you know, what to look for, where to feel the baby when they move for the first time. For example, my baby is on the right hand side, and definitely when I started feeling her, I felt her on that side. And now that she's much bigger, she's about 3.5 pounds, which that information was just given to me yesterday. We had our 30 week appointment, and it's so crazy. She's 3.5 pounds and she moves like she's 3.5 pounds. Like, I can feel her like bulge on my belly, and actually, like, I can see sometimes how like my belly is like bulged a little bit on this side rather than this side. I can feel her sometimes on this side when she like stretches and moves, but for the most part, she's like, let me show you guys. She's like this. Like, this is my right side. So she's like her little feet here, and then she goes like diagonally down to like my pelvic area. So I definitely know she's on the right hand side. And I'm not sure what kind of questions you may have when it comes to Bicornuate uterus, since it's not very common. But from my experience, the doctor did tell me, I had an appointment about 2-3 weeks ago, and she was like, oh, your baby is breached. And she had been breached for about a month already. So the doctor had lost hope as far as her flipping into head down position. So she automatically was like, okay, so we're going to book you for a C-section at the end of August, which it's my due date. She just did it 1 week before. And I was like, wait, what? And it was the first time my husband was there with me. So he was like, wait, already? Like, what? And I was like, I was only like 28 or 27 weeks when she was already trying to book my C-section. And I was brand new to this. So I was like, okay, just book it. And she's like, yeah, if she miraculously flips, then we can go ahead and cancel it, and then you can have a natural or regular vaginal birth. And I'm like, okay, well, that's fine with me. At least we have like a date saved. But yesterday when I went, well, if you guys saw my 4D vlog video where we took the family to see the baby in 4D, the tech there told me that she wasn't breached anymore. She wasn't fully in position. She was kind of to the side, but she was head down. And I was like, what? Like, we were so shook, because literally that week prior, the doctor had scheduled the C-section. So fast forward 2 weeks later, which is now yesterday, I went and the ultrasound tech at my hospital, I was like, oh, well, her head is up here, so you might want to start there. And she was like, no, honey, your baby is head down in position. And I was like, what? We were so shocked. I was like, oh my God, like, that is so crazy. Like, the doctor had said it'd be a miracle for her to flip because of my Bicornuate uterus. And you know, miracles do exist. Now, I'm not getting like my hopes up all the way high as far as like not having a C-section, period, because you never know. Like once you're in labor, I could be pushing and she may not want to come out vaginally and a C-section is needed, which I'm totally fine with. I am okay with whatever it is that gets her out safely and that I'm safe as well. So that's one thing that you have to have in mind as well. You can't go in there with your birth plan and specifically saying a vaginal birth and non-medicated or medicated and not this and that. No, you have to be open because once you're in labor, like everything can change. So as of right now, I'm very open to everything. Like I have my, you know, thoughts and opinions on certain things, but I am open to whatever keeps her healthy, her safe, and myself safe, because I know that if I'm safe and healthy, my baby's gonna be perfectly fine. But definitely keep in mind that even if you have a bicornuate uterus, your baby can be head down in position for a vaginal birth if that's important to you. I originally just had in mind that, okay, a C-section, it's for me, because that's what bicornuate uteruses usually get. But I'm happy that she flipped. She is measuring about half a pound more than, like, let's say the what to expect app says. But the doctor did say she's average, so she's good. But yeah, I definitely wanted to update you guys that if you do have a bicornuate uterus or any kind of other uterus malformation, there is a probability that the baby can flip, regardless of what the doctors say, because she was like headstrong that she would not be able to flip because she's running out of space. And yesterday that I was speaking with the ultrasound tech, which she was like an older lady that's been doing this for like 100 years. She was like, oh no, your baby has space, perfect fluid, she's head down, it's just now when she's ready. And then when my husband came in, and we told him like, oh, she's head down, like she's perfect, ready to go. And he was like, so what do we do now? Like, when do we go to the hospital? Because he was like so stuck on like, we have a date and time for the C-section. And then the lady was like, what do you mean? Like, now it's until your wife goes into labor and starts feeling pains or water breaks or whatever. And he was like, oh, okay. And I was like, yeah. Like, once we were leaving, I was like, now I'm scared. I'm gonna possibly push out a baby out of a small hole. And that is scary. And he just looks at me like speechless. Like, I don't even think he could believe like the baby had flipped either. We were excited that she did, because I do know that recovery is much faster when it's a vaginal birth. And the fact that I have stairs in my home and our bedroom is upstairs, I knew that for C-section I'd be like confined to my bedroom most of the time, to try and heal faster or not to strain myself too much. So that was something in the back of my mind, just as far as recuperating. But I'm so excited that she did flip. Hopefully everything goes well for labor. I am due towards the end of August. But bicornuate uteruses do tend to have preterm labor, so I'm mentally prepared for that. That's why I feel like I'm in the home stretch already, which I need to hurry up and fix everything for her to come to a nice home for her. So definitely very excited about that. Now, if you guys have any other questions or feel like I missed so much to talk about, please leave them down below in the comments or send me a DM on Instagram, which I know most of you guys have reached out to me that way. But thank you so much for subscribing. And if you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe because I do post videos weekly. So thank you so much for watching. And let me give you guys a little quick bump date. I am wearing my belly band if you could see it. This is 30 weeks. Let me see if I can move you guys a little. This is what 30 weeks looks like. It's a pretty round belly. It's not true that your belly will be all lopsided when she's moving. Yeah, it may like bulge out a little, but the belly is pretty even. And she's in there comfortably. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, leave them down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, bonitas.